Good morning and thank you, Sister Gugu. Allow me to greet the saints of God once again in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We have made it yet again to another day, not because of our own works, nor our own wisdom. It is all through the mercies of God. Thus, indeed, we can say this morning, His mercies are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. And we can testify of this, of that, because we have had a privilege of yet receiving another day. Just as a disclaimer, I promise you that I did not call Sister Gugu that the theme of this morning is green and yellow. Anyways, allow me to invite you to read with me as we sit together at the feet of Jesus. In the book of Matthew, chapter 5, and we will consider verses 1 till verse 5. Matthew, chapter 5, we'll consider from verse 1 till verse 4. And I am reading in your hearing. Now, when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up on the mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Verse 4, where we are this morning. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. May the good Lord bless the reading of his word, now and forevermore. Amen. Yesterday, when we looked at our introduction to the book of Matthew, chapter 5, we were able to come to terms with the fact that those that were sitting at the feet of Jesus, they were longing for the kingdom of God. The reasons why they were longing for this kingdom of God was because of the iron fist that was upon them by the Roman governance. Some of the others that were there in the presence of Jesus, they were longing for his kingdom because they wanted the material possessions. They thought that the kingdom of God is about material possessions and gaining status of this world. Some of them, they wanted to be in the presence of Jesus, or they were longing for this kingdom because they wanted to be emancipated from the slavery of poverty, because some of them, they had the smell of fishermen. Every day they would go out and they would go and fish in order to make a living. So to them, the kingdom of God was a vehicle to a place that was better, where they will no longer have to fend by fishing, wearing the same clothes as they were wearing the previous day. And some of them who are there at the presence of Jesus, they sat at his presence because they were longing for the words that were going to come out of the mouth of Jesus. And therefore, as Jesus was in their presence, he was able to see through them. And he was able to see, even in their hearts, the words that had not been expressed. He was able to relate to their feelings. When we get to verse 4, it is as if Jesus had used a microscope of heaven. It was as if he was able to see what these people, they were carrying emotionally. It was as if he was able to see the scars that was within them. It was as if he was able to see the burden that they were carrying of their sins, the sorrows, the trials and tribulations that they were encountering. It's as if Jesus was able to hear the groaning that they were making. And thus he proclaimed verse 4. Blessed are those that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Because Jesus knew that according to them, the coming and the presence of the Messiah was the end of their trials and tribulations. However, when Jesus comes, he does not come and ends their problems. However, he rather gives them a reality of what is to come. He rather gives them a reality of what is to unveil in this cruel world that they are living in. He gives them a reality that is going to take place between the present as he was addressing them and the future that is to come when they will be comforted. He tells them that in between the present and the future of them being comforted, there is going to be a reality where you will get married and the husband that you thought will love you, the husband that you thought will protect you, will become the very source of your pain. He gives them the reality that the children that you sought and you prayed for to God, and you thought they were the blessing that God has ever given you, they will become the tears that will fall off your eyes because of them not having a life that has a direction. He gives them a reality that between the present and the future of being comforted, there is going to be sicknesses that will come. He gives them the reality that between the present, as he is addressing them, and the future of the comforting, there is going to be poverty and unemployment. But he says to them, despite the fact of the trials and the tribulations that will come in between the future, in between the present and the future, be of cheer, take heart, because I, the Messiah, have come. And in the present time that you will be suffering, allow me to say to you that Christ was saying, despite your sufferings, take heart, because the God who takes the anthropomorphic form, the God who takes the human form, is a God who says, when you suffer, I will suffer with you. So that when you feel weak, I become your strength. Be comforted in the fact that as I come to you as the Messiah who will emancipate you from your slavery. Yes, currently, you may be struggling, but allow me to say to you, God says to them, I will surely set you free. The struggles that you are currently facing, they are not permanent, but the situation that you are facing is temporary, because I, God, will surely come through for you. Yes, there will be time of mourning, but there will also be time where I will comfort my people. You will not cry forever, for I, the Lord, I am the Lord who is in control of your future. Here Christ is trying to show them that yes, you will suffer. Yes, there will be trials and tribulations in your life. But the mere fact of my presence here, it is to say to you, in my becoming or taking the human nature and living amongst you, it is for me to be weak in order that in my weakness, you may be strengthened, so that when you encounter trials and tribulations, you may know that you pray to a God who knows what it feels to be rejected, because he was once rejected. He says to them, I take the human form in order that you know that when you feel as though people have rejected you, the ones that were supposed to love and protect you, allow me to say to you, Christ says, I take this anthropomorphic nature in order to relate to you, so that when you pray, you know that you are praying to a God who was once rejected by the ones who was his own. The Jewish people, they neglected Jesus. They rejected him and saw him as an outcast, though he was of their blood. Oh, friends, allow me to say to you, there are times in our lives when we are rejected by the very people who are supposed to love and protect us. There are times in our lives when we have felt in pain, we have felt left alone, we have felt helpless, because the people who are supposed to love and protect us have rejected us. But allow me to say to you that Christ says to the people who are at the feet, I know, I understand, I took this human nature in order for you to give hope, for it is only a God who suffers with humanity, who is able to relate to them when they are suffering. And therefore, allow me to submit to you this morning that yes, you may feel as though God has left you, but allow me to say to you, there is time that is coming when you shall be comforted. What you are currently going through now, it is temporary. God will surely come through for you. Allow me to say to you, if you think though that God has forgotten you, if he was able to remember Joseph in the pits of Egypt, in the deep dungeons of Egypt, allow me to say that he will surely remember you. If God was able to come through for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego when they were in the fiery furnace, he remembered them. Allow me to say to you, God shall also remember you. Allow me to say to you, when Hannah went to the temple and she could not express her words and the grief that she was feeling inside her heart, God was able to hear her prayer. Allow me to submit to you this morning that God hears your prayers and you surely will be comforted. Allow me to say to you, at the feet of Jesus, in the presence of Jesus, there is healing. At the feet of Jesus, in the presence of Jesus, there is hope. Allow me to submit to you that blessed are those that mourn for the Son of Man, those close to them. Blessed are those that mourn, for God suffers with them. When they cry, he cries with them. When they feel weary, he becomes their strength. When they have no hope, he becomes their hope. He elevates them to higher ground. Allow me to submit to you this morning that divorce that you're going through and you feel that all hope has been lost, allow me to submit to you that the Son of Man will lift you to higher ground. Allow me to say to you that tears that are falling are from your eyes due to the circumstances of your children taking drugs and becoming victims of alcohol abuse, allow me to say to you that our God is able to alleviate those problems from your surroundings. Allow me to say to you, we serve a God who's a comforter. We serve a God who never forsakes his people. And therefore, allow me to submit to you that his grace is able to sustain us during the present until the time of our comforting. Allow me to say to you, oh, it is good to sit at the feet of Jesus. Thus the hymnist sings, sitting at the feet of Jesus, where all mortal men can be blessed. There I lay my sins and sorrows. Oh, friends, sitting at the feet of Jesus, there I love to weep and pray. For when we weep and pray at the feet of Jesus, there we receive strength. Oh, friends, let us sit at the feet of Jesus till the day of our comforting. For God shall surely come through for us. For God shall surely wipe the tears from our eyes. Till then, may the grace of God sustain us. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray. Our kind and loving Father, our gracious God who art in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for your blessings. We thank you, Lord, for being a God who suffers with us. We thank you for being a God who takes the human nature in order that feeble humans like us, when we feel weary, when we question you, when we doubt your presence in our lives, we may be able to say, yes, indeed, blessed are those that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Yes, we may lose our loved ones. Yes, we may be suffering through unemployment. Yes, we may not have the tuition to pay for our children. Yes, we may be going through divorce, but we thank you, Lord, for Calvary. We thank you, Lord, for the privilege of you having to take the form of the human nature, to die on the cross, so that when we do not have hope, we can say there was one who died on the cross, so that the humanless, the hopelessless people that we are, we may be resurrected and rejuvenated in our faith. Thank you, Lord, for your grace. Thank you, Lord, for your mercies upon us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Indeed, a wonderful Savior our Father is, that despite our sufferings, our Savior is close by, and we can be assured of the comfort that he will give, because he's a God who not only remembers, but a God who sees all that we go through. And as he promised in John 16, verse 33, that surely we will overcome and have the victory because he has overcome. Siyabonga mfundisi. May the good Lord richly bless you. Today.